The Philippine Trade Department says it does not suggest requiring COVID-19 vaccination in the hiring process. Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez says the most employers could do is to state their preference for fully vaccinated job seekers. Lopez suggests incentivizing vaccination instead.
Sa maraming nag-a-apply ay preferred nila yung vaccinated. Kumbaga may additional point ka for hiring kung ikaw ay vaccinated. Ganun din sa pag-existing workers. Hindi nila pwedeng paalisin pagka hindi vaccinated. Pero pwede sila maglagay ng mga incentives para dun sa mga vaccinated. Let's say sa promotion, mas may merits, positive merits ka pag vaccinated and the like.
Labor groups reject President Duterte's statement it's legal for employers to turn away unvaccinated job applicants. The Trade Union Congress of the Philippines points out vaccine cards are not considered mandatory requirement for employment as stated in the COVID-19 Vaccination Program Act.
Gustuhin man natin na mabakunahan lahat ng mga manggagawa, subalit mayroong batas na hindi pwedeng pilitin, hindi pwedeng i-discriminate yung mga manggagawang hindi pwedeng o hindi pa handa magpabakuna.
The Employers Confederation of the Philippines says government should continue encouraging people to get inoculated instead of threatening them.
I think what we should do is just be consistent. People are suspicious when you try to force them. They should just keep hammering rather than threatening people or giving incentives. Problem really is we have not really been good in the rollovers of the vaccine, especially in the provinces. Why do you want to create why are we running after those who are hesitant when the numbers are growing smaller and smaller?
The Philippine government raises the vaccination target for its 3-day nationwide COVID inoculation drive. Officials are now aiming to vaccinate up to 15 million people from November 29th to December 1st. The previous goal was for just 5 million. Vaccine Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. says up to 5,000 vaccination sites will be used for the program. And so far, more than 35 million Filipinos have received their first dose of a COVID vaccine, while over 30 million have been fully immunized. The Labor Department mulls raising the deployment cap for Filipino health workers. That's amid calls from those in the medical profession to increase the allowed number of nurses being sent overseas. The cap, which has been set to ensure the country has enough nurses amid the pandemic, is set at 6,500. But the limit has already been reached.
Meron na naman panawagan ng mga healthcare workers na kung maaaring dagdagan. Sabi ko, teka muna, kausapin ko muna ulit yung Professional Regulation Commission, yung Philippine Nurses Association, at siyempre ang Department of Health, kung kaya pa ba natin na magpadala ng additional healthcare workers. Ating mga nurses are the most preferred medical care workers sa buong mundo. Germany nga lang, ilang beses na ako kinukulit ng ambassador nila. They need 15,000 nurses and healthcare workers. Kaya lang sabi ko, hindi namin kaya yan.
Now, as we mentioned, Philippine senators have begun the plenary deliberations for the proposed 2022 national budget. Senator Franklin Drilon opened the proceedings by underscoring what he says should be the Duterte administration's thrust next year.
The 2022 national budget should provide the much needed impetus for economic recovery and not because of the election. Ito po ay budget ng taong bayan, budget ng ating bansa, hindi po budget ng mga kandidato. The 2022 national budget, Mr. President, is the key to our recovery. Walang sektor ang dapat maiwan.
Senate Finance Committee Chairman Sonny Angara presented his proposal to allocate 61 billion pesos for the procurement of COVID-19 vaccines as the country continues to ramp up its inoculation drive. He also assured the public next year's spending plan is loaded with government aid.
Over 100 billion. Health pa lang, that's 91 billion moving. Tapos dun sa education, that's another 10 to 15. Then dun sa meron tayong DOLE na 2 billion, DND na 2.4 billion, DILG 1.2 billion, DFA as mentioned earlier, DA. Oh, so we're talking between maybe 100 to 150 billion.
The Philippines records 2,646 new COVID infections Wednesday. The health department also reported 99 more deaths and 4,000 recoveries. The country's positivity rate has fallen to 4.3%. That's the first time since January 31st that it's fallen below the World Health Organization's 5% benchmark.
This is a milestone. It's actually even better because in the NCR, the positivity rate has dropped to 3%. We're testing enough and the cases are decreasing. The reason tests are going down is because fewer people are getting COVID. And generally, the approach is that we're testing those who show symptoms or those who were exposed. So if there are fewer people showing symptoms and fewer people getting exposed, then we will be testing less.
The Philippines' COVID Interagency Task Force set to discuss the possibility of further shortening the quarantine period for travelers entering the Philippines. The issue was raised at the Senate during the first day of the plenary deliberations on the 2022 budget. Senator Ralph Recto questioned government's policy requiring quarantine for travelers from countries under moderate risk classification.
So why not, kung nabakunahan ka na sa Amerika at pupunta ka ng Pilipinas, o OFW ka, you're required to quarantine pa rin? If we don't take this issue seriously and we don't study this carefully, how do you open up the economy? How do you open up our tourism?
Secretary Galvez has assured us that they're going to discuss it and they're going to merge the green and the yellow so that they could have less quarantine and attract more foreign tourists.
The Octo Research Group is supporting that move for a shorter quarantine period for select travelers.
If it's a true green and yellow list, I wouldn't mind it actually. We should be okay as long as we're following these strict guidelines of testing them, even for vaccinated individuals.